KK Java tutorials. In this video tutorial, we will learn how to create a parameterized job in Jenkins, right? So what is parameterized job in Jenkins? So basically when you try to create a job in Jenkins, right? So while building your project within Jenkins, if you want some of the parameters should be selected by the basically developer while building the project, or they can enter the few parameters, right? So if you want to give this kind of provision, then we required a parameterized job within the Jenkins. So let's try to understand through an example, through a use case. So here what I'm going to do, if you look into, I have a project in GitHub, and this project is now named Ticket Booking Service JUnit Testing. So it's a Spring Boot project, and here you can see I have a three branch, right? Master, develop, and stage, right? So I'm going to create a job, parameterized job for this branch in Jenkins. And there I will give the provision to the user to select the branch name, which branch they want to build. Yeah, I hope you understood. So this is the use case I'm going to take over here. So I go to the Jenkins. Before going to the Jenkins, let me copy location of this project, right? GitHub location of this project. Just click over here so that this URL will be copied. Now here I'm going to start everything from scratch. So click on the new item, and here I'm going to specify let's say this job name similar to this guy. Let's say underscore to this is job name I have given, and here I'm going to select Maven project and click on OK. Now once you click on the OK, then configuration stuff we have to provide on the next page. So here before proceeding for the parameterized job, let's configure this job a very simple fashion, and then after we'll convert into the parameterized job. Right, so here some of the things we need to provide. So in this category, source code management, I'm going to select Git. Yeah, here I need to specify the repository URL. So here you go and copy this repository URL and paste it over here. Yeah, make sure that this is ending with .git. And as this project is completely public repository, so I don't need to specify a credential. Otherwise, if you are working in an organization, then click over here, and here you need to specify username, password, ID, and description. Description is not mandatory, right? So, but my repository is public one, so I don't require to specify credential. Yeah, so Git related stuff I have provided. Now scroll down, and here if I go to the build setting, I think rest of the things here in the build section goal option we can provide here, root pom pom.xml. here we can specify the goal option like clean package, so that if there is any build build happened through the previous build, and that build will be basically deleted, and that will package again, right? So I think most of we have done. Now I'm going to click on apply and then save. Yeah, now if I go to the dashboard, then here you can see this job I have created. So let's try to run this job. Right, so here you can see build now is coming, right? So once you convert this project into parameterized, then this name will get changed. So we'll see how. So now let's run this job first of all. Now build has started running. Let's see, look at into the console. So build has started, so a lot of dependencies getting downloaded from Maven. So this project is a Spring Boot project with a lot of dependencies. So first time if you are building, then that may take some time. but second time onwards this will take less time. Here you can see 12 test cases has been executed, 0 is failed, error 0, escape 0. Yeah, so now build is succeeded, right? So now I'm going to convert this project into a parameterized project, right? Now click on this arrow and go to the configure, and this configure section, all right, in general tab, you'll get this option. This project is parameterized. If you select this one, then you'll get this drop down. Select here, you'll get different kind of parameter you can configure over here. So here I am going to use git parameter, right? So by default this option will not be available in the Jenkins. So if you want this option should be available in your Jenkins, then you have to install a plugin is called a git parameter plugin, right? Once you install that plugin, then this option will be visible over here. So I'm going to select this one. So now here here you can see parameter type. So as you know, when you are working on a SEM like git hub, then you can have a tag, branch, right? Branch or tag or revision or pull request, right? So here I would like to select the branch, right? So let's say user, I would like to give the provision to the user, right? So which branch they would like to basically build, right? So of course these things you can do easily by here you can just change, let's say if you want to build the master, then by default it is master, right? If you want to basically build develop, then simply manually you have to go and you have to specify the develop or stage, right? So if you look at here, there are three branches, right? So manually you have to modify, apply, save, and then you have to build, right? I don't want that one, and that's why I want to make it parameterized, right? So here if you select the parameterize, I select branch, then here you have to specify the default value, right? So default value is mandatory. So here by default I'm going to specify origin slash master, right? So user doesn't select any branch, then master branch is gonna build, right? And here I'm going to name, I'm going to specify any name, you name meaningful name you can specify. So I say branch name, okay, and that's it. Here you can specify select branch which you want to build. Yeah, and of course we have done. Now if I go apply and save, right? So earlier it here we were seeing build now. Now it is showing build with parameter, right? And here you can see same job is there. So now if you click over here, then here you can see all the branches, right, for this git repository available on the git, which is getting fetched, right? And here you can see origin slash master, origin slash stage, and origin slash develop. Let's say I do not select any branch and click over here. Now let's see the behavior of how it is getting building. So here you can see by default master is getting builded, right? Build has started from master branch, right? Origin master. Let me complete this build. By default master has been selected. That's the default behavior, right? What we have configured till it. Now build is succeeded, right? If you go to top, as if you see here origin slash master, right? Now again I go back, okay, and here at this time I'm going to select let's say a stage branch, right? I would like to build the stage, right? Here I have given the provision to the user to select the branch name and click on build. Now at this time a stage branch is going to build, right? Here you can see branch name, that must be a stage. I think I'm not sure. So here you can see a stage has been built, right? A stage branch has been built. Now let's say I would like to build the develop branch, right? So I go to here again. I need to select the develop, right? So select develop and click on build. And at this time, develop branch is going to build, right? Here you can see branch name develop is gonna build, right? So in that way we can create a parameterized project, right? Now there are few more things I'm going to show you. Sorry guys. So here if I go to the again configuration, right? If I go to the configuration, and here there are many more kind of parameter you can see over here. Like you have a choice parameter, right? So let's say I'm going to name as choice, and choice you can specify like x, y, z, right? So here let's say environment you can take from the this parameter, different kind of like develop, develop test and all, right? Description if you want you can give, otherwise it is just option. Apart from that, let's say choice parameters, multiple, this will give you the drop down. Apart from that, there are many kind of parameters. This is already we have seen. If you want to take the password, then this is the one. Then a string parameter is very popular. So let's say I would like to take the string from here. So here let's say I'm going to specify the name. Developer can specify the name. Default, I'm going to specify KK, right? And let's say apply and save. Now if I go and click on the build with parameters, so there are, no, before that, sorry guys, this is before that what I have to do. So here you can see the drop down has came. Here default name KK is coming, right? Now this parameter, how we can pick up within the job. So that that things is still pending. So click on the again configure, and configure you can go to the build, I think build or something else. Let me go to the build settings, sorry, build environment. Here you have to go, and here in build environment what you can do, we have a two options, right? Here very lot of options are there. One is execute Windows batch command, another is called execute shell. If you are working on Unix or Linux, then you have to select this one. If you are working on Windows, then execute Windows batch command you have to select, right? And here we can do echo, right? Echo. And Windows, of course, we can display something like this, right? So first parameter was choice, right? choice, right? So this will display the whatever value user is going to choose in the log file, right? And second echo we want to do for the name, right? So second one, I think name, I'm not sure whether this is all in capital or small, right? If you want to display these things you want to echo on Unix or Linux, then this parameter should be preceded with the dollar. Yeah, so that's it, I think. Let me check out those parameters how I have renamed. So this was renamed choice, right? This was renamed name, right? And that's correct, right? So now apply, save. Okay, now if I click over here, right? And let's say I want to build the master only, and here I am selecting Y, this parameter, and name is selecting, let's say I'm specifying PK. If I click over here, if you go to the log files, then here those value must be displayed. So here if I search for KK, PK, right? PK. Here you can see the PK is getting picked up, right? PK, right? So this value easily we can pick up, right? So here you can see this value echoed, right? And we had selected in drop down, we had selected Y, so Y is getting printed, right? So that's all I have in this video tutorial, guys. So In this video tutorial, you have learned how to create a parameterized job within the Jenkins, right? And what's the advantage of parameterized? So sometimes your project requires some parameter should be selected before start building, or some of the parameter user has to basically provide, a user has to enter. So this kind of situation comes, then you require a parameterized job within the Jenkins. So guys, big thank you for watching this video, and see you there in the next video tutorial.